Hello students, let us see an important topic from multi-threaded programming using isAlive and join. So isAlive and join are the methods that we are using with respect to multi-threaded programming. So in the preceding example, in the previous examples, we used to make a call for the function sleep within the main, that is to stop the thread or to pause the thread with a long enough delay to ensure that all the child thread terminate prior to the main thread. So this is a key point you should note about. So all the child thread or sub thread what is created should be terminated prior to the main thread or termination of the main thread. However, this is hardly a satisfactory solution, and it also raises a larger question, that is, how can one thread know when another thread has ended? Of course, that's why messaging is required, isn't it? Communication is required, or synchronization is required. The status of the other thread, one thread, should be known to the other, because the relationship, there may be a relationship, parent and child relationship. As per this, the sub thread or the child thread should be terminated prior to the termination of the main. Fortunately, thread, the class, built-in class thread, okay, with T capital, which provides a means by which you can answer this question. In the previous videos, we have discussed about this, that is synchronization or message passing. Two ways exist to determine whether a thread has finished or not. So, first you can call, there is a method where you can estimate or you can identify whether the thread has done its execution, whether thread has finished or completed its execution or not. One is making a call for the function isAlive. I'll highlight, just go through it. Here. This method is defined by the thread class, and its general form or syntax. See, its return value is a yes or no, that is of type boolean. So final boolean is alive. This is what the syntax of the function is alive, which is defined under thread class. The is alive method, which returns true if the thread upon which it is called still running, that is thread is still alive. Which thread you want to test? It will give you the status whether the thread has completed its execution or still it is working or running. So if return value is true, you can think still the thread is running or working. If it is false, then of course thread has completed or has done its execution. While isAlive is occasionally useful, the method that you will more commonly use to wait for a thread to finish, which is called as join method. Okay, the syntax of the join method, final void join, throws interrupted exception, of course. This is what the syntax of, it can throw the exception, recall the exception handling concept, which we have discussed in the previous sessions. This method waits until the thread on which it is called terminates. Okay, this function, join function, waits until the thread on which it is called terminates. Until the thread terminates, this method will wait. Its name comes from the concept of calling thread waiting until a specified thread joins it. Additional forms of join function allow you to specify a maximum amount of time that you want to wait for a specified thread to terminate. Okay, in terms of seconds or milliseconds, we can define. Duration or interval we can define on that is the maximum waiting time. Till that time it will it will be waiting for the termination of the thread. Here is an improved version of the preceding example that uses a join to ensure the main thread is the last to stop. Of course, the main thread should be terminated last. The sub threads or child thread should be terminated first. It also determines the isAlive method. Here is a small example program. Okay. New thread is the name of the class what we are going to create, which you recall the topics from the previous previous session, that is previous videos, right? Either it should be extending the thread or it should implement the runnable interface, right? To include the properties of thread, your program, the class which you are going to create, either it should extend the built-in class thread or it should implement the runnable interface, right? Here we are considering, we are implementing the new thread, that is the custom class what we are defining. We are implementing it runnable interface for this. So string variable is declared for name, that is the name of the which refers to the name of the thread. Then thread class object reference is created, that is T. Then as you can see, the constructor of new thread with one parameter. So thread name, what is given? No string, that will be assigned to name. Then initialize the thread class object. Thread class object is initialized here. T equal to new thread of. This is the pointer, right? This pointer is used, which will refer to the invoking object always. Fine, we will be printing the thread here. New thread is a message followed by value of T. That is what printed, thread name is printed here. Make a call for the start function. This is to initialize the thread. So to initialize the thread execution, start module is called here from the constructor. Of course, constructor is the default executable module whenever the object is created, isn't it? Next we have the run function, right? We have mentioned a delay of 1000 milliseconds. Thread dot sleep is taken. So we are printing the values from 5 to 1 actually. I starts from 5, I greater than 0, I minus minus, right? Then it is included inside the try module. So corresponding catch block, interrupted exception catch block is mentioned. Okay, this is for termination. Then you begin with the main function. So main function is included inside a separate class module, demo join. We are creating three objects here of the new thread class, right? New thread ob1, ob2 as well as ob3. It takes a string as a parameter because you can, as soon as the object is created, object of new thread is created, its constructor will be called, isn't it? It has got only one version of the constructor. What is that? New thread, right? New thread of string thread name, isn't it? Yeah. So after that you print thread 1 is alive. Okay, make a call for the is alive function with respect to ob1 t dot is alive, ob2 t dot is alive, as well as ob3 dot t dot is alive for the three object what is created. Then make a call for the join function with respect to each object, ob1, ob2 as well as ob3. Okay, now check the output. Again, those is alive function is called after join. Once again, is alive function is called with respect to all the three object. Okay, check the output of the program. Output of the program, what happens is actually, sorry. So this is what the output of the program, guys. First, we are creating three object, right? Three objects are created. As soon as the object is created, its constructor is called. So check the main function. Main function, it has got a object creation, new thread ob1, ob2 as well as ob3. 1, 2 and 3 we have named. Then, so what happens is here. So this module, new thread, this constructor module will be executed, right? So what will happen? You are passing the name 1 followed by 2 followed by 3 for the three different object, new thread each time it is created. write new thread followed by name of the t. Then thread execution begins. T dot start is called start to initialize the execution of the thread. So what happens here in the output? It displays like new thread followed by name of the thread. Right? What is the name of the thread? Thread followed by 1 followed by the value of I. Value of I given as 5. So initially all the three threads, it will be having the value of I as 5. Later we are decrementing it to 1. 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. 5 different iterations will be carrying out. That you can see here in the run function. Isn't it? Check here inside the run function. Check here inside the run function. Value of I given as 5. Right? Fine. That is for the three thread. Next what is done? Check the main function. Here you are making a call for the isAlive function to test whether the thread is alive or not. How many threads you have created? Main thread you have created? Three main thread you have created. You have named them as 1, 2 and 3 respectively. Please try to understand. So with respect to the first object, you are making a call for t dot is alive. See first object. What is first object? OB1. Write it separately. Use the dot operator. Then using the thread object t, make a call for is alive function. Is alive, which will return either true or false. Just now we have discussed about it. Right? So of course thread 1 is just started and it is running. Obviously the return value will be true for the first thread, second thread as well as the third thread. As you can check the output, it will return true here. See, thread 1 is alive is true, thread 2 is alive which is true, thread 3 is alive is true. What else is there? Then next we have a try block. Inside the try block there is an executable statement. This will be printed waiting for threads to finish. So waiting for threads to finish, this will be executed waiting for threads to finish, followed by OB1. You are making a call for the join function, t dot join function. So with respect to OB1, you are making a call for t dot join. What happens? So it prints like value of the thread, value of the I actually. See, for the join function, value of I will be printed here, name of the thread followed by colon followed by value of I. So run function content will be printed. What is the name of the thread? Name of the thread is 1. What is the value of I? Initial value is 5. So it looks, it prints 1 followed by colon followed by 5. That is for the first thread. Similarly, other through two main threads we have, isn't it? 2 as well as 3. So a string will be displayed, 2 followed by 5 and 3 followed by 5. As you can see them in the output, right? 1 followed by 5, 2 followed by 5 and 3 followed by 5. Now run function, which takes a delay of 1000 milliseconds, then it will decrement the value. What is the value? New value of I. New value of I will be 4. As you can see, for I is 5, I greater than 0, I minus minus. You are supposed to print the value of I. Name of the thread followed by value of I. So after this interval, what is the interval? 1000 milliseconds. What is the new value of 1? So again, same string will be printed, 1 followed by colon followed by value of I. What is the value of I? 4. Similarly, 2 followed by colon followed by 4, 3 followed by value of I, that is 4, will be printed. Then next interval, value of I will be 3, 2 as well as 1. As you can see the output here, right? 1, 2 and 3, new values will be printed. Then again new values of I, 1, 2 and 3 after some interval. After certain interval, 1, 2 and 3, its new value. Value of I is 2, that is printed. And 1, 2 and 3 new value of I, that is 1, 1 and 1 respectively, that is printed. So the last value of I, printable value, is 1 only. After that the thread terminates, isn't it? The thread will be terminated after the name of the thread followed by exiting. Okay, this will be printed, name of the thread. There is no exception caught, so interruption message will not be displayed. The 2, 3, 1, whatever the order it can be. So 1, 2, 3 it can be. So thread 2 exiting, 3 exiting, 1 exiting, whatever. Then next we have, in the main function again we are making a call for the isAlive function to check whether the thread is alive or not. Now all the threads are terminated. Of course they will not be alive now, they will be terminated, they are already terminated, isn't it? isAlive will return false now. Earlier it has returned true because thread was started and it was getting executed. Now we have terminated, we have stopped the execution, I mean we have completed the execution of all the three thread, 1, 2 as well as 3, and we have printed the message as well. Again, for the sake of convenience, for the reference purpose, isAlive is called to check whether still any thread is running or not. So we will be getting false as the value now. As you can check here, see, thread 1 is alive, which is false. Thread, it is because it is terminated already. 2 is alive, false, and thread 3 is alive, which is also false. A final message will be printed. What is the final message? Main thread exiting. So this message statement will be printed at last. Please note down the program and analyze how does it work. So analyze that, watch the video once again. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section given below. Otherwise, you can reach me on WhatsApp. Thank you. See you in my next video.